My money don't jiggle jiggle, it folds. I like to see you wiggle wiggle, for sure. It makes me wanna dribble dribble, you know, riding in my Fiat. You really have to see it, 6 feet two in a compact, no slack, but luckily this.
Hello everyone, my name's Dean, and let's talk crypto. This is where you subscribe for daily Bitcoin updates and technical analysis. We track the price of Bitcoin as a proxy for the cryptocurrency markets at large. Today is July 4th, 2023. And it seems as if our full moon retracement has played out. I know this isn't a massive retracement, so it may or not be the case, okay? It may or may not be the case. Remember, the studies show, and there's really sort of, there is rigorous data to support this claim, right, that on a full moon, 0 to 3 days after a full moon, rather, we typically experience a market pullback, a retracement, and then the opposite is true 0 to 3 days after a new moon, okay? So we're always looking out for some sort of retracement on or near a full moon, and the full moon was officially the third, and actually, on the third, we got a retracement, okay? I was saying in my analysis these past couple days that it was likely that we break out and then get a retracement, right, from the full moon, possibly, you know, on the third day, second to third day after the full moon. But it seems as if, and I don't know if this is true, but it seems as if this is our full moon retracement. May not be the case, okay? May not be the case, because we still may have, if we do break out eventually, yeah? And before we get to that, let me say this. We have been in a range for 11 days for Bitcoin, okay? 11 days at this level. Very important level, okay? People may be underselling the importance of this level. 30,000 was a milestone for Bitcoin, right? On the way down last year. And now on the way up, it's a staunch resistance. But what has happened in the recent past is we've found resistance at this level, okay? And now reclaimed it, okay? So this is the reclamation right here, this bit here. As you can see, you have some corrective price action here. And you can see basically the old resistance is now made into support. Old resistance is flipped into support. So 30K is now your base, okay? And so now we can look to, with confidence, move up from $30,000. If you're bearish, you don't want to see this. You don't want to see a great deal of time consolidating at resistance. Yes, it may mean distribution, but this doesn't look distributive. And it would be more compelling to say it's distributive if we were below this level right here, okay? This level that was heretofore resistance. If you zoom out on the daily time frame, let's get rid of the moon phase indicators. I think we get the point with that. So if you zoom out, you can see exactly what I'm talking about, right? Just look left immediately. You can see that was your resistance right here. 30,500, right? And here, this is now your support. You broke that level and you're resting on it. You're flipping. This is what we call RS flip. Previous resistance flipped into new support. So this is a big reason for our bullish thesis in the immediate and medium short term. Okay. So we have that. Now let's zoom in a bit on the hourly time frame. Guys, if you're getting value, please like, share, and subscribe. And look at this 11-day range, okay? So it's just, it looks like it's just, you know, a random up and down range. But as I said, really, what you want to focus on, if you're trading this, is this bit right here. This bit right here is showing an uptrend, okay? Higher highs and higher lows. And it's a very clear, strong, well-defined uptrend, Okay. On that 45 degree angle, my Wyckoff people, or sorry, my GAN people love their angles, know what I'm talking about. This is very confidence boosting for continuation to the upside. It's not too steep, it's not too shallow, and you're getting a retest of the, what would you call that? The ascension line, right? You're getting a retest every single time. So you go up, you retest this. You go up, you retest this. Very, very likely that this serve as a launch pad for a breakout, okay? And remember what we're doing here. This is not just any kind of breakout. Zoom out for a second, okay? If you zoom out, you'll see what I'm talking about. This breakout from this level is epic. The breakout from this level, one of the reasons, you know, it makes sense to be bullish here, and it makes sense to be really excited about the market as long as it's taken at this level, right? 11 days. One of the reasons it's so smart and, you know, high probability to be bullish, even though you're consolidating for 11 days, is because a breakout of this region means a breakout effectively of all of this, which one could say represents the bear market accumulation, okay? The bear market for Bitcoin can be defined as everything after that June 12th, or was it June 12th or June, whatever, this is on the weekly time frame. So it's that the first week of June, that capitulative candle right here. And now this is kind of your bear market accumulation. But for me, I define bear market as the declension, so the drawdown, plus the accumulation, all right? And now the bull market for me technically starts January 1 when your uptrend starts. However, although, and I've said this before on the channel, although the technical start of the bull market can be set to be January 1st for Bitcoin, right, where you have five waves up, three waves down, five waves up, a version of three waves down. This is a complex flat correction, probably a WXYXZ, something like that. And what you're now getting is very likely some sort of extended wave five, right? That's what it's likely to be, okay? So the breakout of this isn't the start of the bull market per se. It's not the technical start of the bull market, but it is the start of the market feeling bullish, because up until now, you've been under resistance. And what resistance are we talking about? We're talking about the resistance of this entire bear market pattern that broke down, yielding the bear market, right? So basically, you've been under resistance since about May of last year, May of 2022, okay? Once you broke this level at 30K, okay? And now you're finally reclaiming that level, which should make everything feel more bullish in Bitcoin, feel more bullish in crypto, right? If you look at alts, it's a different story, and alts are just now coming out of their bear market accumulations. A lot of alts are all the way down here. So it's a different story altogether. But if Bitcoin starts running like a crazy person, right, because it isn't under the pressure of, you know, this massive resistance of, you know, a year plus, right? This level that we're breaking right now is an 800 day level. Once Bitcoin breaks that, it feels like a bull market, even though the technical bull market can be said to have started on January 1st. The other thing I want to address on the Bitcoin chart is there are some people saying, hey, Dean, I get that. I agree with that analysis more or less. But if you're correct in saying that this is an impulse and, you know, we're going to continue this impulse above 30K to print an extended wave five of some sort, wouldn't it make sense for us to have a regular three-wave retracement of this five-wave move? And to that, I would say yes and no. Remember, when you're really bullish, you don't necessarily have to pull back extensively at resistance. And you can see this on the small time frames. We're going to look at that in a second on an altcoin or two, just to drive the point home. So what you see here is a retracement, is a pullback, but it's relatively minor. And it serves the purposes that price wants. So price hit the resistance, right? An 800-day resistance, it pulled back. Did it pull back massively? No, it pulled back, modestly, and finally broke up. And now it's retesting previous resistance as new support. Had you not done this, I would say you're more likely than not coming back down for a retracement of these five waves. But in this case, what you're likely to do is continue this move. And the tricky bit about talking about targets, and this is another thing that I didn't mention in last video, talking about targets, it's not so easy when you're bullish or in a trend, bullish or bearish, doesn't matter, right? Trends are trends. In a trend, it's not so easy to say, oh, we hit resistance, now we can expect a wave two retracement or a wave four retracement. No. Because you don't know the type of retracement that price action is going to put in. You know it's going to put in a retracement. You don't know if it's going to put in any major retracement. So that's my answer to that. And that's also why my target is tentatively, and that's the operative word, tentatively 50K thereabouts, only because that would more or less yield a target of this inverse head and shoulders, right? A target of this inverse head and shoulders, if you want, as well as a target of this bull flag, right? This is your flag pole. This is your flag, right? And it would give us the higher high on this previous high, which you would want to establish in any trend, right? You want to establish higher high. If it's a downtrend, you want to establish a lower low. So I believe 48 to 50K is my next tentative target, tentative, because what may very well happen is that we get to this point around 48, 50, 55, or let's say, remember, I kept saying for months, 41K is our next target, easy, because that's the technical target of this inverse head and shoulders. So that's the same point I'm trying to make. You can get to 41K and then just experience a bit of short time frame consolidation and then just continue. So that target was technically met, but it wasn't your ultimate target. It's tough to call ultimate target. That's kind of what I want to say. That's why I'm saying more or less I'm expecting at the very least a move to 48 to 50K, which would give you a 57% move thereabouts in Bitcoin. Okay. How long would that take? I have no clue. Is it going to take all the way, until the next new moon where we can expect the next local market high? I don't think so. I think that's something that comes in a matter of days, especially once we get above the 30K resistance and we just start moving and grooving. Okay. And now, as promised, I'm just going to highlight the point of, not necessarily being able, I think synthetics is a good example in a small time frame, not necessarily being able to call a retracement and expect a big retracement. So watch this. So synthetics, it has been retracing or consolidating for the past few days, just like Bitcoin, but a little more aggressively. Yeah. So you could see an A wave. This is clearly a B wave, and then this is your impulse, right? So that's your ABC flat correction, boom, 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 yeah. So now that you've found support, you're retracing, Okay, now let's zoom back into this point of interest here. You can see that you've started to put in impulse, and you clearly have resistance here because it was support for so long. You broke down, now you're back up. It's not necessarily the case or the fact that you're going to have to do this, right? A 618 or 0.5 Fibonacci retracement of this wave. What you can do is simply, and I don't know, but this is very possible, and I wouldn't be surprised if this happened, simply do something like this and continue. Same thing for what we were looking at on Bitcoin on the higher time frames. So it's hard to say what kind of retracement you're going to get. What we can say with a higher degree of probability as analysts is that because you're at resistance, you're going to experience some resistance, you're going to experience some consolidation. The nature, the exact nature of that consolidation, we can't necessarily say. To close out the video, I'm just going to say that a lot of analysts said we weren't going to get much of any price action today because of the market's closing, right? The traditional market's closing because it's a bank holiday. It's the July 4th Independence Day in the US. But what they fail to realize is that the DXY still moves. Why? Because the DXY is the US dollar against a basket of world reserve currencies, right? And those world reserve currencies, the Swiss franc, the French franc, the British pound, and so on and so forth, those six world reserve currencies that the dollar is traded against to yield the DXY or the US dollar currency index, those other currencies, those other markets are open because, you know, July 4th isn't a significant day. It's not a bank holiday in Europe, or right, in Britain, in France, in Switzerland, so on and so forth, in Japan. So this is why we've gotten some movement in the DXY, and the DXY has really been not very interesting, right? You've gotten a lot of consolidation over the past few days, and it looks as if in the immediate short term, you've got this 0.618 retrace, right? You've got a wave down, right, which is clearly impulsive, and then you got a retracement to the 0.618, and you're at that resistance. So if you pull your Fibonacci retracement level, you can see from the top to the bottom, you can see that this right here, let's pull this like so. Okay, this right here is a retracement at the 0.618. And it's more likely than not to have found resistance over here. Okay, can it go to the 786? Yeah, sure, and make it a flat correction. But I think it is a zigzag, and you're going to find resistance here, just like you found it here, right? And finally turn around, and that is what's going to give us our pump in Bitcoin and crypto. Okay, if you look at this on the higher time frames, the hourly, you can see that the hourly momentum indicator is topped out. The 4-hourly momentum indicator is getting close. Okay, the next candle closes at 7 p.m. So that's getting close to topping out. The daily is completely topped out. The weekly is topped out, right? So we're close. We've been close for a while. But as I said, it's really clever to be bullish at this moment in time, given what the charts are telling us. Guys, if you've gotten value, please like, share, and subscribe. I hope you are well positioned to take advantage of this move. This is going to be a massive move, the likes of which we haven't seen for a very long time in the crypto markets. Take care, and I will see you. The crime of less majestic, and the police, because they can't arrest me.
My money don't jiggle jiggle, it folds. I like to see you wiggle wiggle, for sure. It makes me wanna dribble dribble. You know, riding in my Fiat, you really have to see it. 6 feet 2 in a comp.